I'm Alicia, and we are Rosebud AI. So what we do is enable virtual production for digital talent on demand. And I'll go into exactly what that means, but some of the motivations are the problems that we're trying to solve, which are, you know, fairly obvious facts. So one, video and photo shoots are costly. They are also slow and time consuming to create. And finally, there's also a very timely need for a remote friendly production process. Especially right now. So what we do is we specialize in creating digital media of virtual talent on demand. And this could be somebody's digital double, or it could be completely based on, you know, beings that don't exist. And so a lot of my background comes from research in deep learning, and in particular, GANs, generative adversarial networks, that are responsible for some of the more wacky results in deep fakes that you see in the media. And I also spent some time in venture capital. And so I saw an opportunity where there was a lot of, I think, creative augmentation potential in a lot of the tools here. So aside from, I guess, some of the more dystopian use cases, I really wanted to sit in the front seat to mold it towards more creative ones. And so what we're building is supposed to address some of these problems. So on-demand creation, editing of photos, focusing on virtual talent, so faces and people, and to make it affordable and accessible for just, I guess, more small business owners. See it as really putting the tools of like advanced production processes to sort of more hands. And finally, I think just an interesting kind of thing of the times is that this happens also to be fairly pandemic proof. And so we've seen more organic interest as a result of COVID, just because a lot of the more physical based processes aren't possible right now. So what was nice to have has evolved more towards a need to have. And so some of the vision that really kind of drives us and makes us really passionate about this stuff is, think of it as like enabling storytelling at the speed of thought. So creating visuals, creating characters, if you can sort of do this in an on-demand process, you're really enabling people to tell stories much more with less friction. So that's kind of what we're motivated by. So, okay, now just to share some visuals and videos of our products. First thing we launched last year was this thing called Generative Photos. It is a web app where we do on-demand generation of these photos, mainly based on like the faces and creating attributes for the face that that correspond to what brand owners and marketers really want. It's a virtual process, obviously. It's done with deep learning. And one of the value props that we discovered for a lot of these people is that they didn't want to end up using the same stock models as a lot of other companies, especially their competitors, which is a shockingly kind of common thing that happens, at least with startups. It's available at app.generative.photos. And this is a quick GIF of how the app actually works. So you can go in there and start altering kind of on demand of any photo that you submit and upload. Here's some more examples of V1 of the product where we, fixed on several identities that we can kind of directionally change a photo towards. Starting with photos really allowed us to learn better what customers wanted to control. And so, you know, going back to the vision of like, what is, like some storytelling at the speed of thought, we also wanted to take our learnings to full body shots. And so there was an obvious other application within fashion that we got some demand on. And so we started training models to generate the entire body. And so this is the virtual model product. Value prop is fairly obvious for the retail industry as it's faster time to market. Again, and here are some examples of how that works. You can customize the faces. And then more recently, we jumped onto videos, and it's a very kind of logical step in our pipeline, because by focusing on people and creating virtual beings, a lot of the same processes and architectures that we use for generating photos can be moved into video. And so after we gained learnings about the kind of control that people are care about in terms of their creations, that then can be optimized in the process for creating videos. And so this is a project which we called Humans of AI, and how I got connected with Ibran sort of this collaborative fiction. We had access to the GPT-3 API, and so I decided to create these prompts for just fictional characters. And because there was text, we can actually use this new video generation pipeline that we've designed, where can create a new face with the original photo product, use the text and then actually feed into
the Sikh religion is a very straightforward path to peace. Our gurus teach that there is only one God, and no one can reach God but God Himself. And that's the truth. Nothing can happen that is outside the will of God. If you're sick and you die, it's God's will. If you're healthy and alive, it's God's will. So every time I go to the doctor, I thank Him for keeping me alive.
So yeah, you can learn more about the project at rosebud.ai, but none of the text was human written. And this is just kind of to serve, I mean, obviously it was trained on data that was written by humans. And so it was very interesting to just kind of feed it prompts that were very similar to the humans of New York Project and see what it dreams up and then pair it with the visuals because, you know, we're all very visual beings. And so being able to animate it has kind of given it new dimension. I think also what was interesting about this is then some of the inbound for our new video product has come from very, I think, creative and artistic backgrounds. And so even things that we wouldn't have thought about, which, you know, include maybe film directors who wanted to just scope out an initial kind of like a reading of their script, like this kind of technology really kind of showed them that, okay, maybe I can do that on demand in a not very, you know, like obviously this is not in the end production product, but it really helped them kind of imagine how their characters should look like. And so combining our ability to make faces with the ability to animate them to enabled that kind of process. Here's another example. Again, this is kind of interesting and I guess in a more thought-provoking way. So this one generated something about a cop and he's, you know, also...
I'm a cop. It's my job to serve and protect, but it's been a long time since I've been able to do that. I used to see people trying to help each other. It was an honor to serve and protect them. And to see them, you'd think they were more...
You know, Bronze also generated some characters as well, so you should check that out. And so finally, you know, this alludes to what Talking Heads was also originally envisioned to do. Some people who wanted it for instructional videos and promotional videos. So here's
this elegant entertainer's dream home is available for private showings this weekend. 5 bedrooms, 3 full bathrooms, and a half bathroom with detached guest cottage on a sunny and...
So this is still in private beta, and what we're trying to do is also include the full body into the generation, because, you know, very rarely do we have just the head sort of speaking to you. But yeah. And then lastly, just for fun, we've released a lower dimensional or lower resolution consumer version of this app. And to sort of combat any malicious use cases, there's more caricatures of political figures that you can find on talkingheads.com. But here's an example where you can just actually input not text, but audio and get it to sync automatically to a photo.
Enough guy, just always so puff guy. I'm that bad type, make your mama sad type, make your girlfriend mad type.
Yeah, and so I get a chuckle out of this, but I think actually one of the other speakers in this conference is the creator of Lil Miquela. So yeah, I think just anything for people are trying to tell stories with either virtual or real personas, this can be a tool in their arsenal. Oh, and finally, just to show the more examples of like real audio clips, Lana Del Rey released some red poetry in audio form. And so you can actually just pair it with her face and it generates this more, guess, the video dream.
I left my city for San Francisco, took a free ride off a billionaire's jet. LA, I'm from nowhere, who am I to love you? LA, I've got nothing, who am I to love you when I'm feeling this way and I've got nothing to offer?
So as you can see, the video product is still in its, especially the consumer version, they're in nascent stages, but we're honing on it fast. And I think there's a lot of interesting use cases that can help creators here.